Ricki-Lee is a woman reborn with a new look and outlook on life. She's had 6 top 10 singles, made 2 gold-selling albums, signed with legendary UK record label Ministry of Sound, and is Australia's most successful female idol. She's returning to her roots as a mentor for the next generation of Australian idols. Now, after 3 months recording in the US, she's back with her most personal album to date, charting her recent marriage breakup and return to happiness as an empowered woman, perfectly captured by her new number one single, Don't Miss You.
We've missed her. Welcome back to the show, Ricki-Lee!
My goodness.
Hello.
Hello.
Congratulations, Ms. Number One Single.
I know, that's very exciting. I'm number one on the independent music charts and the physical charts for ARIA. So, as an indie artist, most people don't know I'm signed to an independent record label. So it's a big deal for us. And you know, we don't have the big budgets of the majors. We have to make up for it in brain power and hard work.
So does that mean people love a Screw You song in this country?
Of course.
So we're like,
who doesn't?
So I, Mr. X. Ricki-Lee, has he heard the song? Because it is about him, isn't it?
Well, look, as much as I would love to say that, you know, the song is about a fling that I had with Mr. Alice Cooper a few years ago, it wasn't. I've only had one relationship. So, yeah, it's quite obvious what it's about. Well, look, there was a little incident last year that you may have read about.
Oop-a-day.
Yeah.
So, was it helpful getting through all of that and having the music to make that a bit of an easier process?
Well, as a songwriter, I mean, you write from experience. You write from the things that you go through. So, you know, I went overseas, spent 3 months travelling and you know, writing this album. And it is quite personal. You know, you do delve into, you know, the things that happened over the last 12 months. Of course, I can't avoid talking about it. I mean, there's no grey area. It happened.
But that's pretty much the whole song. Does that mean... Because the song is, you know, there's... Yeah, I call you a creep, but if I said anything more than that, it would be bleeped out. It's pretty much one of the lyrics.
Well, it was...
But also, too, you mentioned about travelling and getting a tattoo. Yeah. So have you got a tattoo now?
Well, it's very odd. Yeah, I do have a tattoo.
Where?
I can't tell you. Well, I can't show you.
Is it in a Rudy place?
It might be.
Interesting. And so...
It might be.
Now, does that mean you also got caught nude again? Because last time you were here, you got caught dancing publicly nude. And so has that actually happened again?
Well, okay.
You're just giving it away.
Well, it could only happen to one person twice in a lifetime, being caught in the nude. I did get caught dancing naked again.
So where this time?
Well, where I reference in the song, caught dancing in the nude, which I did tell here last year, which happened in Thailand. I got caught dancing in the nude. There was another time in Mexico. I did, you know, 3 months of travelling. The last stop on the map was Mexico for a week of just winding down after, you know, a long time of intense, you know, creative whole studio. So I was just in Mexico, and first day we were there, we're seeing this beautiful, beautiful cliffside palace kind of thing. It wasn't a palace, I'm over exaggerating. No, it was this beautiful, beautiful house in Pedregal in the hills and in Cabo San Lucas. And the first day we were there, I'm laying out there tanning, topless, as you do, thinking that.
I sunbag topless.
You see?
You are such a whore.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Better I can see everything.
No, I was just, you know, just got the girls out and I was tanning and relaxing. I didn't really know, but there were maintenance house people that come and look after the house.
Oh, good.
That had keys and come at any time and you don't know when they're coming and they just walk in. And I may or may not have been laying there and having a little snooze. All of a sudden I look up and there's this Mexican pool cleaner with this pool cleaning gear and grills and going,
I've seen that movie.
And he had the biggest smile on his face and he was kind of just standing there like, hey. But they just come in at any time and you don't know that they're
dating life's going well for you again? Are you back out on the scene?
Well, yeah.
People, your guys watching at home, do they have a shot?
Sure, why not? I mean, there was a 16-year-old in Bali that had a go. Why not?
Hang on. Say that again while I sip.
There was a 16-year-old in Bali that had a go. No, seriously. I got picked up by a...
No, come on, you're out there now. You got the ladies out again.
I just shouldn't travel. I shouldn't travel. I shouldn't leave Australia.
No, every man on the planet is saying, travel, travel.
Travel. No, I was in Bali, and it was the first stop. It was the first place we went to. And newly single, enjoying the male attention. But not really the male attention that I got from a young gentleman in a nightclub. Anyone who's been to Bali knows Bounty. It's a fantastic nightclub.
Sure.
And, this... He looked quite young. But most Indonesians do.
Sure.
They're just youthful and beautiful. And, I'm...
Well done on correcting what could have been a very racist remark.
No. I'm, like, and 6 foot tall as well. So he's he's up to my girls. He totally came up and performed for me.
And at what point did you find out he was 16? Hopefully.
When he took me to the bar and asked me if, you know, he's like, can I buy you a drink? And I was like, yeah, sure, why not? And, he bought me a drink and proceeded to ask me what my name is, how old I am, and I did the same with him. And he, I didn't know what his name was, but I did remember that he was 16 and he had just bought me an alcoholic beverage. So. And it wasn't just any drink, it was like one of those giant.
So you're officially a cougar then?
I am.
Congratulations.
So you can say the whole dating thing's going well.
Well, on that, are you ready for your public probe, Ricki-Lee? Someone could hit on you with this, you never know.
Oh, look out.
Okay, number 5 from Ben in Victoria. Have you ever broken a bone?
No, I haven't broken a bone, but I have had a knee reconstruction.
Oh, was that from the netball days?
Yeah, from the netball days, I had a knee reconstruction, so that was quite painful.
So
that's fairly
similar. Number 4, Joey from South Australia asks, what's the one thing you never leave home without?
ladies, my handbag. Handbag, which has everything in it, and I can never actually find anything in it.
Okay. So. WA. Number 3, if you could be any fictional character, who or what would you be?
Oh my gosh. Yeah. Any fictional character? What's something that I liked as a kid?
Probably Stifler's mum.
Yeah.
There we go.
Tegan in Queensland, number 2. Have you already, or actually, I'm going to read this whole question out in its entirety. Have you already, or do you think you're going to get swine flu? And what is your favourite colour?
Random. Well, my favourite colour is purple. And yes, I have been to Mexico. I managed to be in Mexico while there was a worldwide pandemic of swine flu.
Of course.
And then flew into Melbourne, which is the second highest. And I managed to not get it, so I'm fine. I'm fairly confident.
You are immune.
I'm
and number 1 from Troy in Victoria, is it true that you can play the trumpet?
Oh, no. Are you serious?
Is it?
Well...
Because otherwise, this is going to be shit house.
Oh, no. You could have asked me...
No, that's not as fun.
Do you play trumpet or have you played trumpet? Very different things.
Can you purse your lips and make a noise with this thing?
Okay. Oh, no.
Would it help if we said the trumpet was 16 years old?
Well, here I go then. Oh, no. I played this for like 2 months in high school to get
so
out of
yes
class.
Is the answer.
No, not really. Hang on.
We'll be the judge
of
that.
I've got lip gloss on.
It's fine.
Is that good enough?
That's perfect. There we go. Put that on the next CD.
You want a trumpet player?
That would be great. That sounds great. Just play that one note.
Well, Ricki-Lee single, Don't Miss You, off her upcoming album, Hear No, See No, Speak No, is in stores now. Thank you, Ricki-Lee.